हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम रितिका जुजगर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर आईटी डिपार्टमेंट. सो इन द कोर्स ऑफ कंप्यूटेशनल ऑप्टिमाइजेशन वी स्टार्टेड अवर सेकेंड फोर्थ यूनिट, दैट इज द गेम थेरी. सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज मीन बाय गेम थेरी एंड व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द गेम थेरी. सो इन दिस वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द गेम थेरी. सो first characteristics is a competitive game. So the competitive situation is called as a competitive game. So if it has the following four properties. So first property is there are finite number of competitors, such as n is greater than equal to 2. So if we are having the case is n equal to 2, so it is called as a two person game problem. Okay, so but if you are having the n is greater than 2, so it is referred as a n person game. Okay, so the second property is each player has a list of finite number of possible activities. The third property is a play is said to occur when each player chooses one of his activities. So the choices are assumed to be made simultaneously. That is, no player knows the choice of other until he has decided on his own. Okay, so this is the third property. And the last property is every combination of activities determines an outcome which results in the gain of payments to each player, and provide the each player is playing the uncompromisingly to get as much possible. So negative gain implies the loss of a same amount. So these are the different properties in the competitive game. The second characteristics of the game theory is the strategy. Okay, so in the game, first we require the set of rules or a set of strategies. So each player has a different strategies. So in the game theory, the second characteristic is the strategy. So the strategy of a player is the predefined rule by which the player decides his course of action from his own list during the game. So there are two types of strategies are present. First is a pure strategy and the second is a mixed strategy. So in the pure strategy, if a player knows exactly what the other player is going to do, so the deterministic situation is obtained and objective function is to be maximize the gain. Okay, so in this case, player already know how the another player is going to be perform. Okay, so what is there, another player has a strategy, the player already knows. Okay, so this is a pure strategy. So the pure strategy is decision rule, always to select a particular course of action. The second strategy is a mixed strategy. So in that, if a player is a guessing as to which activity is to be selected by the other on any particular occasion. So the probability situation is obtained and the objective function is to maximize the expected gain. Okay, so in the pure strategy, the deterministic situation is obtained and we get the objective function maximize the gain. And in the mixed strategy, the probabilistic situation is obtained, we get the objective function maximize the expected gain. Okay, so this is the difference between the pure strategy and mixed strategy. So in the mixed strategy is a selection among the pure strategies with a fixed probability. Okay, so if you are having the pure strategy problem, we know already the player, another player is what exactly is going to be performed. Okay, so this is a deterministic situation and we get the objective function is a maximize the gain. But in a mixed strategy, we get the probabilistic situation and perform the objective function based on the maximized expected gain. So this is another characteristics of a game theory. The third one is a number of persons. A game is called as an n person game if the number of person playing is a n. We are having the n number of persons. The person means an individual or a group aiming at a particular objective. So in the number of person problem, we have two person zero sum game. Okay, so this is the example of this number of person characteristics. So if you are having a 2-person zero-sum game are called as a rectangular games, as these are usually represented by the payoff matrix in the rectangular form. So a game only two players, that is player 1, player A and player B, is called as a 2-person zero-sum game problem. So if the losses of one player are equivalent to the gains of the other, so that the sum of their gains is what? Zero. Okay. So the first wala person A is lost the game, and player B is also lost the game. Okay. So these are the equivalent to the gains or the losses. So that the sum of their gain value is what? Zero. So that is why this problem is called the 2-person zero sum game problem. So in the next part we discuss this problem with some examples. The fourth characteristic is the number of activities. The activities may be finite or infinite. The fifth characteristic is the payoff. The quantitative measure of satisfaction a person get at the end each play is called as a payoff. And the last is the value of the game. So at the end we get the value of the game. So value of the game is the maximized guaranteed gain to player A, that is the maximizing player. If both the players uses their best strategy, it is generally denoted by V and it is a unit. So these are the characteristics of the game theory. And the last one is the payoff matrix. If we have to solve the 2-person zero-sum problem, zero-game problem, first we are required the payoff matrix. Okay. And then we can find out the objective strategy and then the value of the game. So what is mean by payoff matrix? Suppose the player A has a M activities and the player B has an N activity. So here the payoff matrix is what? M by N. So then a payoff matrix can be formed by adopting the following rule. So what are the rules are present? First is what role designation for each matrix are the activities available to player A. And the call-off designations for each matrix are activated available for the player B. So sale entry Pij is the payment to the player A in the A's payoff matrix. And when A chooses the activity I and B chooses the activity J. With the zero sum 2-person game problem, the sale entry in the player B's payoff matrix will be negative of the corresponding sale entry Vij in the player A's payoff matrix. So that the sum of playoff matrices for player A and player B is ultimately zero.